Hello, St. Mary's families, students, and staff. What a great start to the school year it's been. It's been so exciting to see the energy that the students have brought to the building this year, the dedication and enthusiasm of our teachers and staff, and the incredible support of our families. I'm very grateful to be a part of this special community. We've come together to celebrate a community over the first 2+ months of school, the back-to-school mass and picnic, the family masses, and the bison benefit. I've enjoyed these opportunities to get to know our students and families more, and I look forward to sharing more of these opportunities with you as we move forward. This is the first principal update of the school year. The purpose is to provide information to our community about what is going on around the school and to share some of our accomplishments. For the November principal update, I'll be covering the following topics: a recap of St. Mary's events, staff updates, talk about our student services team, talk a little bit about what's been going on with our STEM program this year, share some details about iReady, and also talk to you about our North Park University affiliation agreement that we signed this past summer. Coming this year, providing opportunities for us to come together and celebrate as a community was a priority. We hit it off on a positive note with our back-to-school picnic. Not only did we have beautiful weather, we celebrated Mass as a community, served over 200 hot dogs, gave out some great raffle prizes, and spent some quality time socializing to kick off the school year. We've come together to celebrate our faith with several family Masses, including our Little Saints Mass and dinner. One of our school goals this year is for 85% of students to attend at least one St. Mary family Mass. Coming together and celebrating Mass is the most important thing we do as a community and central to everything else we carry out. The Bison Benefit on October 15th at Chevy Chase Country Club was a blast. Everyone who attended had a great time, enjoying some great food and entertainment, participating in auctions, and just socializing for the evening. The members of our community who participated in the Bison Fund, the Bison Benefit, have been incredibly generous. Nearly $110,000 were raised that evening and in the weeks since. A portion of that money raised will go toward enhancing our physical safety and security in our school building. Trunk or Treat on October 23rd was a hit. Over 200 kids in costumes came with their families to trick or treat. Members of the St. Mary community, as well as Carmel High School, the Village of Buffalo Grove, and local businesses decorated their cars and helped hand out candy. The last week in October, we celebrated homecoming with dress down days, a pep rally, and a food and hygiene product drive to support the Little Sisters of the Poor at their work at St. Joseph Home in Palatine, as well as our own St. Vincent de Paul food pantry. We raised 257 items for the Little Sisters of the Poor and collected 1,200 items for the food pantry, which far surpassed our total from last year. Literally, a dad was wheeling in a dolly full of non-perishable foods on the last day of the drive, and the students were rather motivated to raise, get donations, get collections, because the teachers of the top two classes who collected the most items got a pie in the face at our pep rally. Congrats to Mrs. Wenzel and her fourth graders, and Mr. Martinez's second graders for leading the way. Both Mrs. Wenzel and Mr. Martinez were great sports. During the pep rally, the staff took on the girls' volleyball team, and despite the serving prowess of former collegiate volleyball player and current St. Mary PE teacher Mr. Duros, the students prevailed. It was really a great experience as our preschool through eighth graders came together to celebrate our school and the success of our athletics teams throughout this whole season. Speaking of athletics, our cross country and our volleyball teams have had great seasons. In cross country, our girls team ran a great sectional race, finishing in sixth place. And our two boy runners at the sectional meet, Dylan and Robbie, qualified for the state meet and represented us well. What a way to finish off their middle school cross country careers. In volleyball, both our seventh and eighth grader teams entered the conference championship as the number one seed. Both teams played thrilling matches in the conference championship and were victorious, bringing home two conference championship trophies. Way to go, girls. Our community is so proud of you. We have a few exciting events that are coming up that I'd like to highlight. First, Mrs. Olson, our kindergarten teacher, has relaunched our robotics club for third through eighth graders with the support of Jason and Krista Miller. Robotics club will begin in early December and run through mid-March. For our youngest Bison in preschool through second grade, Mrs. Olson will offer a junior STEM program. The program will run after school in April and in May. Both of these co-curricular activities are exciting opportunities for our students and create some exciting, engaging, and fun learning experiences beyond the classroom. I cannot wait to see these programs in action.
In December, the FSO will be hosting the Christmas Bazaar on December 6th. December 7th, our kindergarten through 8th grade students will be telling the story of Christmas through scripture readings and songs at our 20th annual Lessons and Carols. On Sunday, December 11th, we will have our Angels and Shepherds Mass at 10:30 a.m., immediately followed by Cookies with Santa. Our 7th graders will be putting their learning on display with the Science Fair on December 13th. December 14th is the date of our Advent musical featuring our kindergarten, 1st, and 2nd grade students. Finally, get in the mood of Christmas spirit with two exciting concerts. The choir concert will be held in the church on Thursday, December 15th, and the band concert will be held in the Activity Center on Monday, December 19th. I am looking forward to both of those.
I'd now like to shift and talk a little bit about our new hires and our staff updates for this school year. We were very busy hiring this summer, and from the end of last school year through October, we've hired a total of 10 new employees. I could not be more excited with the team that we've put together. Between the teachers and staff who were already on board when I arrived and those we've added, we truly have an amazing team here at St. Mary. I wanted to take a moment and highlight some of our newest staff members. Ms. Emily Sturgeon is our newest preschool aide. She's an alum of St. Mary's School and is thrilled to be back working with our youngest Bison, and we are thrilled to have her on our team. Mr. Phil Duros joins us as a PE teacher. Phil has created an engaging environment in his classes that his students look forward to every time they have PE. Mrs. Sherry Hirschenhaus is our newest preschool teacher. For the past 2 years, Sherry has worked in Hawthorne District No. 73 as an instructional assistant and assistant preschool teacher, and previously was the lead preschool teacher at Little Learners Preschool in Vernon Hills. Sherry was lead catechist at St. Mary of Vernon Catholic Church for 15 years, and is excited to be able to work in a Catholic school environment where she can share her faith with her students. This is Mrs. Betsy Powers' first year at St. Mary as our special education teacher, but this is her 32nd year in teaching. She has loved working with the students and their families, along with the excellent St. Mary staff, providing every child every chance every day. Mr. Darren Rose has been generating a lot of excitement as our new music teacher. Beyond the classroom, Mr. Rose collaborates with Father Rock O'Connor in directing our students who sing at our weekly all-school masses. The response of the students has been incredible. Our first mass of the school year featured a Mr. Rose and Father Rock duet, but we currently have over 30 students participating in our choir at all-school masses.
Mrs. Alex Siotis is our amazing middle school science teacher. Mrs. Siotis completed her student teaching here at St. Mary, and we are fortunate that she has stayed as a teacher. Mrs. Siotis is incredibly creative and engages her students through problem-solving tasks and labs that are challenging yet fun.
We're thrilled to have Ms. Paula Logsden join our St. Mary team as our STEM teacher. Paula worked for many years as a financial analyst and is excited to make the jump to the world of education. We're so happy to have our STEM program back, and we're so happy that Ms. Logsden is the one leading our program. Mrs. Seema James joins St. Mary's, our Director of Marketing. Mrs. James has experience in corporate marketing as well as marketing in Catholic schools. Mrs. James has been key in letting our community and the world beyond St. Mary know about the great things happening here. And if you're not already doing so, please follow us on social media to see Mrs. James's hard work and all the exciting things happening at St. Mary. We're also fortunate to have Ms. Peg Young join our team as our reading support teacher. Ms. Young pushes into our classrooms to provide reading support, as well as pulling out students to work one-on-one or in small group settings. Ms. Young has a wealth of expertise. She has published a book on reading and writing supports and has presented at numerous conferences on reading interventions. Ms. Young gratefully welcomes the opportunity to share her expertise with the students, teachers, and families of the St. Mary's School community.
Mrs. Paulina Metzger joins us as our new art teacher. Mrs. Metzger is no stranger to St. Mary. She's been a member of the community for several years as a parent. Mrs. Metzger has done an incredible job engaging her students and tapping into their creativity. When you get a chance, walk by the art room to see all the amazing student work on display in the hallway.
Related to hiring, I want to take a moment to highlight the evolution of our student services team. We are grateful for the amazing team made up of Mr. Don Enright, our school counselor, Mrs. Powers, our special education teacher, and Ms. Young, our reading support teacher. Additionally, Ms. Kapfer, our middle school writing teacher, as well as Ms. Smeja, our fifth grade teacher, have been going into the classrooms to provide individualized support and small group learning opportunities to students. Whether providing social-emotional education to our students, supporting the diverse needs of our learners, or helping all our students to grow as readers, this team has done amazing work to collaborate with our teachers and support our students to make sure we are meeting all of our students' needs. Also this year, we're super excited to be having our STEM program starting up once again. If you want to get your child excited to talk about school, ask them what they've been doing in STEM. We're so excited to have this program back and could not be happier that Ms. Logsdon is leading the program. I've been amazed by the thought-provoking tasks Ms. Logsdon has had her students undertake, from kindergartners designing chairs that Humpty Dumpty will not fall out of, to our middle schoolers building freestanding towers with limited supplies, basically paper and tape, to our fifth graders building and flying their own kites. Ms. Logsdon has been doing an amazing job of collaborating with teachers to build upon the concepts in STEM class that students are learning in their core math and science classes. We're so happy to provide our students these experiences that will help them develop skills and have hands-on learning experiences that will prepare them not only for careers that exist today, but also for careers that do not yet exist. This is the third year the Archdiocese of Chicago has administered the iReady assessment to measure student achievement and growth in math and reading. This is one of the many important tools that we use to assess our students' academic learning and growth. I want to take the opportunity to just provide some explanations, clarifications, and details about this assessment so that all members of our school community can better understand what information the assessment can give us. Each year, all kindergarten through eighth grade students attending a Chicago Archdiocesan school are required to take the iReady assessment in math and reading. The purpose of the assessment is to identify current levels of student mastery in the concepts tested, as well as measure student growth over the course of the year. The goal is not only for every student to attain grade level mastery by the time the spring iReady diagnostic is given, but to also achieve their expected growth target. The test is adaptive, meaning that if a student responds correctly to a question, the following question is more challenging, whereas if they respond incorrectly, the following question is more basic. The diagnostic is given three times over the course of the year, the fall, the winter, and the spring. Each diagnostic identifies concepts the whole grade level has mastered or on which they need additional support, and to what level each individual student has mastered the content and skills assessed. Additionally, each diagnostic measures the individual growth of students in each area assessed. The first diagnostic given in the fall is crucial. Not only does it identify the information mentioned above, but the fall diagnostic establishes an annual typical growth target for each student. This is a benchmark for how much each student's score is expected to grow over the course of the school year. There's a huge emphasis in education not only on measuring student mastery of content and skills, but also measuring student growth. In fact, one of the system-wide goals established by the Archdiocese of Chicago Office of Catholic Schools for each school in the Archdiocese is that 75% of students at each school will achieve annual typical growth on iReady reading and math assessments by 2024 to 2025. We're also proud to announce that over the summer we signed an affiliation agreement with North Park University School of Nursing. North Park is launching a direct entry Master's of Science in Nursing program, or DEMSN, and this is a program designed for those making career change to nursing from another field. At the end of the program, the students will graduate with a master's degree in nursing. As part of their studies, the students will need to complete a community nursing course. As part of the course, they will visit St. Mary's School, get to know the school community and the surrounding community, identify a health need of the community, and develop a plan to meet that need. Each trimester, there's the possibility of a different cohort or different group of nursing students visiting our school. The nursing students will not be providing medical care to our St. Mary's students, although they will be under the supervision of a North Park professor who is a certified nurse. This agreement does not cost us, nor does it cost North Park anything. I think this is a unique opportunity to partner with North Park to meet a need that they have for their nursing students, as well as to provide a service to our school community. This agreement increases the visibility of St. Mary in the community as the nursing students visit, observe, and experience our school environment. And this program sets us apart from many of the schools in the area. Thinking longer term, having a steady stream of nursing students visiting our school is a plus if one day we have the opportunity to add a school nurse to our staff here at St. Mary. We're constantly looking to provide the best experiences for your children and for you as parents and guardians. With that in mind, we'll be sending out a parent satisfaction survey via email next week. The survey was developed by the Archdiocese for schools to use at their discretion. The results will be made available to the Archdiocesan leadership as well as to the St. Mary's School Administration. Please take the time to complete the survey and be honest in your feedback. I, along with our school advisory board, value your insight, and we will take the time to look at the results in depth to identify what we are doing well and in what areas we can improve. The survey will be sent out by email on Tuesday, November 15th, and will be open until Tuesday, November 22nd. The survey contains 17 questions total and can be completed in approximately 5 to 10 minutes. In closing, I want to thank you for trusting St. Mary's School to educate your children. Our teachers, our staff, and I take our responsibility as educators seriously. It is our passion to work with our students and a privilege to work with you as parents and guardians. I'm grateful for your support, and I'm confident that together we will continue to do great things.